Welcome to ABC Interactive English. This is Henry.
And this is Karen.
Mm-hmm. And today we are looking at day 3 of A Window on the World. And it's called Preserving Local Culture with Old Buildings. And the vocabulary words are...
Square. Square. Many people often gather in this square.
Postcard. Postcard. Each postcard costs $1.
Wall. Wall. Jeff's yard has a wall around it.
National. National. Which flag is France's national flag?
Mm-hmm.
You know, Karen, when I first moved to the U.S., I was a little confused.
Why were you confused?
Well, because of the English name for 万里长城.
The Great Wall of China.
That's right, but you know, 万里长城 sounds so cool, but Great Wall does not sound very cool.
Really? Yeah, the Great Wall of China,
I always looked at it as more like a fort
or like a castle.
Right, okay. Like, you know, like it very majestic, and, you know, and then they just called it a wall.
Which
it really is, because it kept people out, right?
That's right.
It was a wall that kept people out. And
but you just thought that it deserves a better name than the Great Wall of China.
But now that, you know, now that it's sunk in, you know, the Great Wall sounds pretty cool. Because
and easy to remember, it is a wall.
It is a wall and it's pretty great.
That's right. Simple to understand and easy to remember.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the question for today is, according to Carol, what are Adam and Carol seeing in North Gate Square?
According to Carol...What are Adam and Carol seeing in North Gate Square? Thousand-mile-long castle.
Preserving local culture with old buildings.
Adam and Carol are looking around Taipei's North Gate Square.
It used to be ugly here. Lots of buildings were falling down.
Yeah, but now it's as pretty as a postcard.
How old is this gate?
It's over 100 years old. There were walls here too, but the Japanese tore them down.
When I look around, I feel like I'm really in Taiwan.
Yeah, there are some modern Western-style buildings not far from here, but I like this better.
I like those buildings too, but it's nice to see things like this. We're seeing national history.
Explanation 1.
Hi, I'm Jeff.
And I'm Hanny.
Welcome to day 3 of this month's A Window on the World. So far this month, we've talked about old buildings. Old buildings need to be preserved, everyone, especially culturally significant historical buildings.
That's right. Old buildings here in Taiwan should be taken care of.These buildings should not just be replaced with European-style buildings. Okay, let's get started on today's lesson. If you have forgotten, the name of our lesson is Preserving Local Culture with Old Buildings.
Today, we'll be reading a dialogue on the topic of old buildings and the preservation of local culture. There are two characters in this dialogue, Adam and Carol.At the moment, Adam and Carol are looking around Taipei's North Gate Square.
Correct. And the word square is the first vocabulary word of the day.
Square. Square. It's a noun. Today's lesson, everyone, has nothing to do with geometry. So this thing. This is a square in geometry.But for our purposes, a square is something else. For our purposes, a square is an open area in a city or a town that is surrounded by buildings and things like that. Yes, squares like these are usually four-sided, but they're not perfect or regular geometric shapes. For example, there is a square in the center of the village.
那个村落的中央有一个广场，好 ，square， square 这个单字当名词，它有正方形的意思。不过在课文里面，它是指广场。例如 ，Some teenagers were practicing dancing in the square. Some teenagers were practicing dancing in the square. 有一些青少年正在广场上练舞。好，再看一个例句。The hotel is located at the main square of the town. The hotel is located at the main square of the town. 那一间旅馆就位于城镇的主要广场上。好，那今天对话中两位主角 Adam 跟 Carol 正在参观台北的北门广场。Okay, let's hear from Carol and Adam. Carol speaks first. It used to be ugly here, she says. Lots of buildings were falling down.
Now, apparently, things have changed. Yeah, it used to be that way, says Adam. But now, it's as pretty as a postcard. Pretty as a postcard, eh? Sounds good to me. Why? Because postcard...is the second vocabulary word of the day. Postcard. Postcard. It's a noun. A postcard is like a letter that you send using snail mail. Now, what makes a postcard and a letter different is the use of an envelope. A postcard is a card or a sturdy piece of paper that is mailed without an envelope. Okay, more on postcards.Photographs or decorations can be found on the side of the postcard that is not written on. For example, I mailed postcards from each of the places I visited during my travels.
很多人去旅行的时候都会寄明信片，除了寄给朋友，也会寄给自己，看看是自己先到家，还是明信片会先到家。Postcard, postcard 就是明信片，它是当名词来用。例如I got a postcard from London. I got a postcard from London. 我收到一张从伦敦寄来的明信片。On the postcard is a picture of London's Big Ben. On the postcard is a picture of London's Big Ben. 明信片上面是一张伦敦大笨钟的图片。好，回到对话里面。Carol 跟 Adam 正在讨论台北的北门广场，说那边以前啊曾经是断垣残壁，很多建筑物都倒了，不过现在却美得像一张明信片。Okay, everyone, get ready, because Carol has a question. How old is this gate? She asks Adam. So, tell us, Jeff, how old is the North Gate?
I have no way of knowing, but Adam will be answering your question, and Carol's too, shortly, after a break. Anyways, don't go away, you guys. We'll be back soon.
Hi, 收看
就爱讲英文，
我是悠悠，
我是吉安。
今天要跟大家分享一件天大的喜讯。我找到男人。
难什么？
人之前先找到了好房子。
哎呀呀呀 ，OK， 好，我才要问你说而已，说啊，你找到房子了没 ？Have you found an apartment？
Have you found an apartment？
Yeah， 找到了。
找到了。
如何如何？
找到那个非常安静，而且离菜市场很近，而且就在地雷商店旁边。
好，非常的安静。
非常的安静。
你可以说 ，It's in a quiet neighborhood。
It's in a quiet neighborhood、
嗯。Neighborhood 就是你住的那个地方。附近的区域都可以啊，就附近有什么公园啦、啊、小学啊什么的。neighborhood。
neighborhood。
OK， 所以 in a quiet neighborhood。
你知道有多 quiet neighborhood 吗？就是你叫破喉咙都不会有人理你的
quiet。破喉咙，破喉咙，这样哈，那叫破喉咙。对。Okay, 那还有你说离菜市场很近。
重点。
菜市场。
菜市场。
叫做 traditional market。
traditional market。
就是传统市场。OK， 所以很近，你可以用 close 这个字，所以 it's close to a。Traditional market.
It's close to a traditional market.
然后在便利超商。
隔壁。
隔壁。OK， 隔壁就是 next to.
Next to.
It's next to a convenience store.
It's next to a convenience store.
对，还有吗？
而且离捷运站只要走了两分钟，以我的腿长来讲，两分钟是不是很近？
哇，那我差不多走三十秒而已吧。对。Okay, it's only a 2-minute walk from the MRT station.
It's only a 2-minute walk from the MRT station.
Okay, 2-minute walk 就是走路两分钟。那我后面要加 from， 从哪边哦到哪边哦都可以。A 2-minute walk from the MRT station，
是不是很完美？
很完美啊，
很完美。
所以我觉得说，sounds like you found a perfect apartment。
Sounds like you have found a perfect apartment.
Yeah.
可是租金小贵呢？
啊，小贵。
贵松松了。
贵松松。
嗯。
啊，正常的哈。那你就可以说，the rent 租金、the rent is quite expensive.
The rent is quite expensive.
不过这也很正常。你要说鱼与熊掌不可兼得。这句话的英文其实很可爱，
叫做熊掌吗？
对，鱼与熊掌不可兼得。这英文怎么说呢？叫做 You can't have the cake and eat it too。
不是鱼跟熊掌为什么会有 cake 呢？
对 ，You can't have the cake and eat it too。因为呢，你不能拥有蛋糕，然后同时又把它吃掉。这句话在老外的逻辑意思就是说，蛋糕摆在这边，对不对？它是有的状态。你吃了就没有了。好，所以你要么可以看着它，要么就吃掉。吃了你就看不到它了。鱼与熊掌不可兼得。You can't have the cake and eat it too.
You can't have the cake and eat it too.
嗯好深奥啊，好深奥，好深奥。来看一下。
你知道我租什么时候？我租多久吗？
租多久？
我租两天，因为太贵了，我就搬走了。
搬走。
所以来看我们的 live action。
Yo yo, have you found an apartment yet?
Yes. I totally love it.
What do you like about it?
Okay, listen. It's in a quiet neighborhood. It's close to the traditional market and it's right next to the convenience store.
Sounds good.
And it's only a 2-minute walk from the MRT station.
Wow. Sounds like you found a perfect apartment.
Perfect. But the rent is quite expensive.
Well, you can't have the cake and eat it too, you know?
So, can you lend me some money?
Money?
Please. 哎呦。
Explanation 2.
Welcome back to day 3 of this month's A Window on the World. Today, we're reading the dialogue portion of our Preserving Local Culture with Old Buildings lesson.
Before the break, Adam and Carol were looking around Taipei's North Gate Square. Curious Carol had just asked Adam a question.
Right. How old is this gate? She'd asked. Adam, right now, is going to answer her. He's going to answer her by saying, It's over 100 years old.
Wow.
That's old.
It is indeed.Also, Adam has not finished talking about the North Gate and the North Gate Square. There were walls here too, he says, but the Japanese tore them down.
Walls, you say? Walls? What a coincidence, because wall is the third vocabulary word of the day. Wall. It's a noun. A wall is a barrier that divides one place...from another place. Yeah, walls are often used to separate things. Things like rooms, pieces of property, etc. Now, walls on the inside of a building or a room, okay? Those walls are found at the side or the sides of that building or room between the floor and the ceiling. For example, you should not try to run through the brick wall.
我们都不是哈利波特，没有办法穿墙，所以千万不要随便试着撞墙哦。Wall 就是墙壁，它是当名词来用。例如 ，He's hanging a painting on the wall. He's hanging a painting on the wall. 他正在墙上挂一幅画。好，再看一个例句 ：The thief climbed over the wall. The thief climbed over the wall. 小偷翻过那道墙。好，回到对话里面 ，Carol 她很好奇，想要知道北门有多久的历史。那 Adam 告诉她说，已经超过100年喽。那边本来是有城墙的，只是被日本人拆掉了。文中的 tear down 就表示拆除。那 tear 这个动词的三态是 tear, tore, torn。Okay, while standing in North Gate Square next to the very old gate there, something occurs to Carol. When I look around, she says.I feel like I'm really in Taiwan.
Adam agrees with her. Yeah, he says before adding, There are some modern Western style buildings not far from here, but I like this better. He's saying that he prefers the gate to the Western-style buildings not far from where he is. Now, the buildings, the Western-style buildings, they're not bad. In fact, they're pretty good. It's just that the gate is so much better.
Well, Carol says it best. I like those buildings too, she says. But it's nice to see things like this.
Yeah, what they're seeing in the North Gate Square is great. It occurs to me that we haven't asked the question of the day yet.
Oh.
We better do that right now.
Okay.
According to Carol, what are Adam and Carol seeing in North Gate Square?
We're seeing national history, she says.
And here in the final line of this dialogue is the final vocabulary word of the day, the word national. National. It's an adjective. The adjective national describes things that are related to countries or which have to do with countries or nations in some way. Yes, a nation is not unlike a country. Yeah, nation is the noun. National is the adjective. For example, the incident was reported on the national news.
那个事件在国内新闻中有报道。好 ,nation 是指国家，它是名词。那我们的单字念作 national。National 是它的形容词，表示国家的，也可以用来形容全国性的。例如 ,Have you ever been to Taroko National Park?你有去过泰鲁格国家公园吗 ？Jeff 老师有去过。好，再看个例句。October 10th is a national holiday in Taiwan. October 10th is a national holiday in Taiwan. 十月十日是我们的国庆日，那这一天是国定假日。好，当我们看着具有历史意义的建筑物，心理上会有一种情感的连结。那么 Carol 就说，当他看着北门的四周围，就觉得自己真的确确实实是身在台湾。Adam 也同意他的看法，虽然北门附近有一些就是比较现代化的西式建筑，可是他们还是比较喜欢北门。可以看到像那样的建筑是很棒的事情。可以让大家见证一段国家的历史。好，我们在第一天有学过 European style 是用来形容欧式的，那这边出现的 Western style 就是用来形容西式的。好了，那今天课文就读到这边咯。 Okay everyone, with that this month's A Window on the World lesson is complete and it's now time for a break.
Right, see you next month. 休息一下，马上回来哦。
Preserving local culture with old buildings.
Adam and Carol are looking around Taipei's North Gate Square.
It used to be ugly here. Lots of buildings were falling down.
Yeah, but now it's as pretty as a postcard.
How old is this gate?
It's over 100 years old. There were walls here too, but the Japanese tore them down.
When I look around, I feel like I'm really in Taiwan.
Yeah, there are some modern Western-style buildings not far from here, but I like this better.
I like those buildings too, but it's nice to see things like this. We're seeing national history.
欢迎收看全民说英语，我是 Daphne， 今天来跟大家分享三则文法。第一则是表示倒塌的动词片语 fall down， 第二则是传达拆除的动词片语 tear down， 第三则是表达 A 更喜欢 B 的句型 A likes B better。 让我们从表达倒塌的动词片语 fall down 开始吧。 fall down 意思是倒塌，fall 在这里是不及物动词倒的意思，三态是 fall, fell, fallen。 down 是副词往下的意思，合在一起 fall down 字面意思就是往下倒。例如 some trees fell down during the typhoon， 有几棵树在台风中倒了。此外 fall down 可以引申指建筑物倒塌，例如 The scaffolding stops the building from falling down， 鹰架防止建筑物倒塌。 接着来看下一则文法。Tear down 是及物动词片语拆除的意思。Tear 在这里是及物动词，撕开、扯开。动词三态是 tear、tore、torn。Down 则是副词往下，合在一起 tear down 引申指拆除建筑物，为可分动词片语。例如 ，The Germans tore the Berlin Wall down in 1989。德国人于1989年拆除柏林围墙。接着来看下一则文法。句型 A likes B better， 意思是 A 更喜欢 B。Better 在这里是程度副词 well 相当的比较级，意指更加，用以修饰及物动词 like 喜欢，合在一起 A likes B better 就是 A 更喜欢 B。 例如 The hotel is cozy but I like my place better， 旅馆很舒服但我更喜欢我家。以上就是今天的三则文法，全民说英语，我们下次见咯。
A sentence a day.
Hi everyone, welcome to A Sentence a Day with me, Karen. 这个礼拜呢要跟大家讲的就是在租衣服的时候我们会用到的英文。那今天要讲的就是如果遗失衣物必须以原价赔偿。有时候你在租衣服的时候你拿回家你可能就不见了，就忘记在哪里了。那这时候怎么办呢？通常他就会跟你讲说啊，不好意思，那你就要以原价来赔偿。如果20块美金，那你就要付20块美金了， OK? So,如果遗失衣物必须以原价赔偿，这句英文应该要怎么说呢？你可以说 If you lose an item, you'll have to pay for a new one. If you lose an item, you'll have to pay for a new one. Whenever you rent your clothes from a shop, you know, in any case, if you lose it, it makes sense to pay for it, right? So usually it's a store's policy. If you lose an item, you have to pay for a new one. If it's $20, then you have to pay $20. Okay, so let's repeat it again. The sentence for today is, if you lose an item, you'll have to pay for a new one. If you lose an item, you'll have to pay for a new one. And we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
我是 Hanny， 又到我们一分钟的单元喽。那今天我们要一分钟的时间来复习在 A Window on the World 学到的四个单字，同学们都准备好了没？一分钟计时开始。第一个单字叫做广场，广场这字怎么说呢？其实跟正方形是同一个字哦，叫做 square。Square， Saint Mark's Square is one of the most popular attractions in Venice。圣马可广场是威尼斯最受欢迎的景点之一。再看第二单字是明信片，明信片怎么说呢？很简单 ，post 是邮政有关的 ，card 是卡片，合在一起 postcard 是明信片。She stuck a stamp on the postcard. 她在明信片上贴了一张邮票。第三个单字太简单了，城墙、墙壁怎么说？叫做 wall. Wall. The wall is covered with graffiti. 那一面墙上有满满的涂鸦。再看第四个单字是国家的，哎，国家是 nation， 在后面加 al 就变形容词 national. National. 国家的。Taiwan's national flag consists of three colors: red, blue, and white. 台湾的国旗是有三种颜色组成的，红色、蓝色跟白色。太好啦！我们在一分钟之内已经复习完四个单字了，同学们表现很棒，我也表现很棒。那回去也要多多复习，多多造句练习哦。今天的 ABC Interactive English 到此为止，下次见喽，拜拜。